Hi, everyone. I'm former Republican State Senator Phil Harriman, joined, as always, never fails, Ethan Stringling, former Democratic State Senator. We want to talk to you today about the marathon campaign for the 2nd Congressional District here in Maine. Bruce Poliquin barely raised his right hand to take the oath of office, and Emily Kane says, I'm running against him. Campaign finance reports are due out. Looks as though Emily Kane raised about $150,000 or less. Bruce Poliquin, $700,000 already. What do you make of it, Ethan?
Well, I'll tell you, when Emily Kane first announced, you'll recall, a few of us were saying this is awfully early to be announcing, and we were also saying that it was a strange timing because she was toward the end of a financial report, so she only had a month to raise money and subsequently isn't going to have a lot of time to have a big splash, and she's not having a big splash. I would say insiders were saying she needed to raise about $250,000. That would have sort of put her rock clearly at the base of the mountain. I think with this amount of money raised and with Poliquin having raised so much more, it's putting her at a great disadvantage. She's really going to have to pick up her game in this next quarter if she wants to be competitive.
Not only that, but the finance reports I'm told show that Bruce Poliquin didn't self-fund, but I think maybe $3,000 for an invitation to an event. All the rest of this campaign money has been money that he's actually raised. So it tells me two things. One, Bruce Poliquin, the Energizer Bunny as we know he is, has not stopped working hard not only at being successful as a congressman, but also at getting ready for re-election. It also indicates that Emily Kane has already tipped her hand to Bruce that, hey, I'm watching every move you're making, I'm watching every vote you're taking, making him even more aware of how important it is be careful of what he says and how he votes.
Yeah, the early entry into the race, I think, really signaled too much to Bruce. I agree with you on that. But I think what she was trying to do really is to try to keep other Democrats out of the race. And the best way for her to be able to do that would have been to have a very strong report. Again, not as strong as it needed to be. I think Bruce Poliquin was aware he had a two-year campaign, regardless of when Emily got in. He's going to raise that kind of money no matter what. Interestingly, it appears that this is more money than any other member of Congress has raised. So this guy, he's on the Finance Committee. Clearly, there's a lot of money going to come in. We need to watch pretty carefully to see who's giving him that money and how he is voting, if there's any connection.
We do that just for Republicans, or do we do that for Democrats?
We do it for Democrats, too, but we don't seem to hold many of those offices right at the moment.